greatness, they all lie on a straight line. But then the one which are at about 5 billion light years from us, they're slightly dimmer. So what that tells us, that the universe has expanded, and all of a sudden, 5 billion years ago, it started to expand faster. Because those galaxies are further from where they are. Okay? So we have, around us, everybody's behaving normal. But 5 billion years ago, all of a sudden, the universe expanded with an accelerated expansion. So those objects are further out. So then we ask the very same question that Nancy Kerrigan asked. Remember, somebody smacked her on her knees, and the first thing she said, why me, why now? I'm sure everybody wakes up in the morning and says, why me, why now? So Mike Turner, a famous physicist, said, well, the universe is asking the same question. Why me, why now? And again, he's a smart physicist, says, aha, if I give it a name, then everybody would think that I'm smart. So we call it dark energy. So we have dark energy. Dark energy is what caused the universe all of a sudden to accelerate. Do we know what it is? We don't know what dark energy is. We don't know what it is, but we gave it a name. So, the grand total of what we know today. This is the universe. 23% is made out of dark matter. Okay? That was direct consequence of Hubble's Big Bang. Dark energy was just introduced in the last 10 years. 73% of the universe is dark energy. Nobody knows what 96% of the universe is. Okay? The stuff we are made of is about 4%. That's the normal matter. And the stuff we see, the star, the galaxy, etc., is 1%. So 96% is waiting for you, young boy, to discover. And we will be lucky if we'll be still alive when we tell us what it is. Thank you. Oh yes, right. So the last thing that the space shuttle is taking is the alpha spectrometer, which is made by a famous physicist from MIT, Sam Ting. Got the Nobel Prize for discovering a famous particle. There are people from Yale like Jack Sunwise who's on it. And they're going to look for dark matter. We don't know what we're looking, so we might as well look everywhere. We look for dark matter, strange matter. We look at here at Yale. We have detectors which we put underground, in a deep underground, 2 miles underground, to look for those dark particles. I never thought that the space station is useful for anything. It's just a thing that goes round and round in a circle and does nothing. But when I heard about the alpha spectrometer, I said, oh, finally, they'll do something good for society. Who knows? Maybe they'll discover dark matter. It will be awfully interesting if they do. Who is running the show? So, okay. Okay, so you're very correct. So for example, we all know that 65 million years ago, the dinosaurs vanished. Okay, and there was actually a physicist, Luis Alvarez, that came with the theory that a comet exploded on the Earth, created the greenhouse effect, etc., etc. In fact, before the massive extinction of the dinosaur, there was much larger extinction. About 95% of the living organism on Earth extinct. And we think that it's quite possible that there was a supernova that was nearby that exploded, and the UV radiation that came from the supernova made that extinction. So that's maybe what you're referring to. But it is true. There's every few billion years, there is something. A million years, there is something. So, well, I mean, look. Interesting life only exists on Earth about 300 million years ago. Okay, that's when the vertebrate came out, and that's when we came out of the ocean and started walking out. I mean, for the majority of the time, the Earth was solid ice. The sun was not warm enough to make water out of the ice. So for this majority of the life of the Earth, we were ice. Then continents started to move apart, and vertebrates came. So we're only around for about 300 million years. So massive extinction can only occur on that scale. So there was one very big one, about 105 million years. Dinosaur extinct in 65 million, and et cetera, et cetera. We're due for another one pretty soon. Well, it could be another million years, you know.
In the grand scheme of things,
it's like the guy who asked God, how much is a million year for you? And God said, oh, it's nothing, it's just a second. And the guy said, how much is $1 million for you? And he goes, oh, it's nothing, it's just a penny. And the guy said, God, can you give me a penny? And God said, yes, just a second. So yes, it will happen.
So when, what are we doing, the two-week sun
supernova? Oh, the supernova. Well, you see, the supernova that occurred, which we call today the Crab Nebula, occurred actually on July 4th, 1054. The two that Tycho Brahe and his student Kepler saw occurred in 1600. So, you know, it seems to be happening every 400 years on the average. 1600 plus 400, maybe tomorrow. Yep.
I understood you said that supernovas all have the same message?
That particular supernova, there are many of them. The particular supernova that I described, which one star steals from the other, we know exactly it has the same amount of light. But other supernova are different. That's a little detail.
Even if the star that's doing the stealing has a different...
That's the thing. The little object steals mass from the other object till it gets to that critical mass where it explodes. Okay? So I give my student an exercise to calculate how many megaton nuclear explosion is that star. 1.4 solar masses. All of them explode. Okay?
And that's based on the way of the helium and the hydrogen. It's always the standard.
Exactly, yeah. We call this stellar evolution. That's, by the way, what I work on. Before you, there was this young lady, I think. So she wanted to ask, and then here.
How do we distinguish between dark matter and dark energy?
Sorry?
Dark matter and dark energy. How do we distinguish?
Ah, okay, very good. They have different gravitational effects. Dark matter pulls things together. Dark energy push things away. That's why dark energy created the accelerated expansion of the universe.
So if there is more dark matter than dark energy, then we might have the big crunch.
Right, so that's one of the questions. Where did it all come from that it is exactly the right amount that we exist? So again, physicists came up with a beautiful idea. They call it the anthropological principle. All the laws of physics are such so that we can live to tell the story. That's what physics became part of religion in some ways. The anthropological principle is actually a solid physics principle. Why is it the same question that the young person asked? Why is it that it's this and not that? Why are the laws of physics such? They are such so that we can tell the stories and life can come to be. The anthropological principle.
You have a question, Beth?
Oh, yes, you have a question.
Does anyone know how far Beetlejuice is?
The what?
Beetlejuice.
Beetlejuice. Now, you know, you're ahead of me. Can somebody tell me what the Beetlejuice is?
It's the little star on the stage.
Oh, okay. It's what?
Beetlejuice. It's the star
in Orion's
belt.
The star in Orion. Oh, okay.
No, it's not in the belt. It's in one of the corners, the top corner.
God. Thank God. Thank to thee that didn't make me in a... Thank to thee that didn't make me... Boy. Thank to thee that didn't make me an astronomer. Listen, okay, so let me give you the simple answer. I'm not an astronomer, I'm a physicist. So, the Orion. The Orion is in the Milky Way, so it has to be less than 100,000 years. 100,000 light years, right? And we know the next star to us is 4 light years. So it's anywhere between 4 light years and 100,000 light years. Did I answer my question?
Already exploded as a supernova, and we just can't see it until
for sure. Yes, because if, for example, a star explode, it takes as I said,
how long it is.
It takes if a star explodes at the end of the Milky Way, it takes 100,000 light years. So it's 100,000 years. None of us is going to be that long.
100,000.
Even you will not see it.
A star is 100,000 light years away and
it
explodes
as a supernova, we'll only see it until 100,000 years after. Precisely. No chance. Nobody wants to know how we reconcile 5,771 years with
15 years. That's right.
So this is actually a good friend of mine who is a very, very pious Jewish man. That's how we reconcile it. So God created Adam. It's Adam, right?
Adam.
Yeah, it's Adam and Eve. Yeah. So God created Adam on the sixth day. On the seventh day, God was talking to Adam and said to him, "Where is your wife Eve? What is she up to?" Wait a minute. Adam was one day old and is already talking? So, what does it mean? God created Adam as an old man. Therefore, God created the universe 5,771 years ago, but he created an old universe. He created a universe which is 13.8 billion years. See? It's all simple. When you believe in something, you can find a reason to.
Perhaps you said one day in the eye of the Lord could be 100,000 years in the eyes of
the Lord. It's not enough.
Well, I know, but...
But the Lord also said there would be evening and there would be morning, so that put a limit on how long a day could be.
So I think on that note, you can cogitate on this, and thank you very much, Moshe, for excellent.